The remaining demos that we'll see, which involve practical examples of using regression models in the real world, will all use data from Yahoo Finance. So you can go ahead and download the latest data from finance.yahoo.com. This lecture, I'll quickly walk you through the files that are needed. However, if you want to work on the exact same data that I use for these demos, then you might want to download these files directly from a Google Drive folder that I've set up here. Just go to this tiny URL, go to the Learning TensorFlow folder within it, and go to Data inside Learning TensorFlow. Download all the CSV files, put it in the Data folder under your Learning TensorFlow in your data lab, and you're good to go. I'll walk you through how we got this data in the first place. In the search box, look for the S&P 500 index. The symbol for that is GSPC. Click on the historical data link that you see here on screen. Now, it's true that Yahoo Finance often updates this page, and you might find that things don't look exactly the same when you are actually watching this course. You have two choices in that case. The first is you simply download the CSV files from the Google Drive link that I showed you earlier. In the second case, you find the equivalent in the news site. It shouldn't be very difficult, should be fairly straightforward in fact. Yahoo allows you to specify a bunch of options that you can choose to get the data. You can specify the time period over which you want this historical data and the frequency of the data, daily, monthly, and so on. I've downloaded data for a little over 10 years, going back all the way to 2007. And so we have a manageable set of data points. I've chosen the frequency to be monthly. Click on Apply. This will give you a preview of the data. And once you have the preview, go ahead and click on the Download Data link that appears right there. Save the CSV file somewhere on your local machine where your program can access it. Give the CSV file a meaningful name, such as sp500.csv. Follow the exact same series of steps for the stock data for Google. Do this for ExxonMobil as well. We also use the NASDAQ Composite Index in our demos, that is IXIC. And finally, the US Oil Fund will serve as a representative of oil prices. All of these are inputs into our regression models. Make sure that you've chosen the same time period and the same frequency monthly for all the data that you download.